Alright, we'll just give it y'all, man. It's your boy KMO, and I'm back with another video. As you guys can tell by the title, I'm going to be going over the best guard build to make. So, I just recently dropped a few videos, and my first 2K20 video was my stretch 4 build. Today, I'm going to be showing you guys the best offensive threat build to make. This build has mass badges. This build can shoot great. This build can speed boost. You get 86 ball control at 95, I believe. So yeah, right now I'm just picking the pies. You guys know the pies and stuff like that, you know, are key, but when it comes to your like speed and vert strength and stuff like that, just make sure you guys fit like, the playstyle that you want, because 92 speed and 88 speed aren't really, you know, that big of a deal. So that's really up to you in terms of what you want to do with speed and strength and excel and all that. But right here, you guys know, first thing you need to do is just max out your shooting and max out your bat, max out your playmaking. Now now, honestly, you guys don't have to go with the finishing and defense or rebounding that I did. I was just kind of experimenting because I'm not going to be playing guard. I'm just showing you guys the best build from what I've seen in the community so far. I know a lot of you guys don't play big man. A lot of you guys play guard, so you guys are looking for guard build. So, yeah, I'm showing you guys why I think it's the best build. And this is what I put together. So, like I went through, it's a 6'4 shooting guard. And, honestly, just it. I think you should just up your finishing, honestly, myself, because you guys know paint defense since 18 has been pretty broken. It's still broken. You know, there's auto shot contest and intimidator and shit like that, but there's so many badges that just combat like intimidator, like giant slayer, contact finisher, you guys know relentless finisher, and just all those badges just like that. So honestly, just scroll through and change your finishing to how you want it and your defensive rebounding how you want it. But I'm showing you guys what I think is the best weight and height. 6'4 with like wingspan 2 down, I believe, and like 178 gives you the highest strength, speed, excel, and vert you can have while still being at, you know, those peak little things that you want. So yeah, right now I'm showing you guys here, and then at the end I'll show you guys the ideal way to distribute your badges as well. So make sure I stay till the end to see what you should do with the badges. But yeah, also, I want to say thank you guys so much for just recent support on the last videos. You know, we've been killing it in views. You know, just 5.2K is on the way. Make sure you guys go down and follow my social medias as well. And, yeah, let me know what you guys want to see, honestly, like what kind of content. If you guys want to see Stage, Park, My Career, Rec, if you guys want more streams, just let me know. And, yeah, back into the builds right here. You guys see I'm adjusting the weight. And right here, you know, I was looking to see, like, what speed can I get, you know, and have the highest strength. And I kind of found like the perfect balance right here where I get strength, excel, and speed and vert all where I want it. So yeah, right here I believe I go with 178. I can't really see it, my display is kind of small, but yeah, I believe I go with 178. Wingspan I put on 78.8, I believe. I don't know, I'm about to show you guys right here anyway, so it doesn't even matter. Yeah, see, I was just kind of looking at like minimum wingspan, stuff like that, what the arms look like, because passing lane steals are pretty easy still this year, even without, you know, a lot of defensive badges. It's just all about your IQ. But yeah, so right here we finish out picking the wingspan. this build comes with what, 22 shooting badges, 21 playmaking, I think I saw, or 23 playmaking or something like that. So you guys get to distribute your shooting and your playmaking badges all over the place. You guys will see right here you get 4 takeover options as well. You get slasher, playmaker, spot up shooter, and shot creator. I think it's best to go with shot creator with this build, just because dribbling this year isn't really all that. So playmaking doesn't really need to be super, you know, I'm gonna break your ankles and stuff like that, because with your badges you can freeze defenders all year, especially if they reach, bro. You can freeze defenders just like normal, bro. Like if they reach, you get a blow by animation, especially with a Hall of Fame first step. So yeah, I think I'm finalizing like choosing out shot creator right here, and I'm about to cut to the badges as this video is starting to come to an end. You know, hopefully you guys enjoyed. Make sure you guys go down in the description and follow my social media so you guys know when I stream, because the way I'm uploading, my notifications don't always go out. So yeah, right here before I cut to the badges, like I said, make sure you guys go follow my social media. Links are down in the description and on the bottom of the screen. You guys can connect with me on Instagram, Twitter, Snapchat, all that. But yeah, right here I'll show you guys the badges and you know what I decided to do with them. If you guys are looking for a jump shot, Klay Thompson is definitely the way to go. But yeah, you guys see right here 3, you know, and it's the way I allocated my badges and stuff like that. But yeah, this video is coming to an end. Like I said, hopefully you guys enjoyed the video. If you guys are new, make sure you hit that sub button. If you haven't already, make sure you hit that like button, comment, and I'm out. Peace.